My name is Lembit Beecher, and I'm the Music Alive Composer-in-Residence of the St. Paul Chamber Orchestra. As a part of the Tapestry 19 Festival, I've composed a piece called Say Home, which features poetry by Chris Santiago and interviews with 47 members of the Twin Cities communities. You have these 47 different people reading his poem that I've sort of spliced together. I had an idea, and I talked to SPCO about it, but it relied on so many other people.
My name is Ki-young Kim. I'm Artistic Director and Principal Violin of the St. Paul Chamber Orchestra. Our mission is really to create distinctive and transformational experiences. We believe in championing new music and creating new art for our audience. You know, we really started talking about wanting to do a festival that celebrates the new music that we're commissioning, our commitment to things that are important to the humanity of the community, just making music even more relevant to enrich their lives. We've sought to really engage the whole community and our whole selves into this idea of exploring a theme through music. Because we had this residency that was made possible by Music Alive and the League of American Orchestras, New Music USA, it enabled us to really work closely with Lembit and talk about what kind of piece we wanted, what kind of piece he wanted to write, and how this piece could engage the community. So his idea was to actually commission poetry about this idea of how do I recognize home.
I felt thematically that home is something that's very easy to talk about in gentle ways, in caring ways. It's something that's we feel so deeply passionate about and are so willing to protect, or that we are driven to protect. There's this whole group of community members who gave their stories to us, who are willing to open themselves up and share. There is some, I think, just visceral joy in hearing the sounds of people's voices doubled with instruments, or I've tried in a lot of spots to bring out the pitches or the rhythms of people's voices. There was so much energy in the way people were reading this poem. I was able to respond to that with instruments and create this sort of vivid tapestry.
One of the things that drew us to him was his ability to tell stories through music, through instrumental textures, through the way he would weave together words in a way that could relate to our music, our instrumental music. And so we saw great promise in that in terms of how he could work with us. It has all these elements of bringing together words and language and poetry and instruments that I think is unique. I don't know another piece like this. But it also brings this element of bringing the voices of the community.
One of the great things about this piece is that it was able to capture people telling the truth about their experience. I can tell from what was chosen that people weren't trying to game their stories. They used their authentic voice, and we got to hear that, and we got to hear those stories next to each other.
A place, a country in which one dwells.
Which one dwells.
Free.
Also one's birthplace.
I got lost in the music, and then I got lost in the words, and then I got lost in the music again.
I certainly never expected what I saw on stage, and that was phenomenal. Just the physicalness of it, and to hear my voice become a thread in all of what was happening was pretty cool.
We're asking everyone to reflect personally, like, what does home mean to me? And what does this realization of home as a piece of music or a sound mean for me? Our dream is that people are really thinking about this. They go home from the concert, they're thinking about it more. So that's our great hope for this festival, and that we plan to repeat it, and so people will look forward to the next one as well.
The experience of working on this piece has been a really artistically invigorating one for me. I think I would suggest to the audience members hearing this piece for the first time to try to sit back and sort of let the piece wash over them. It's been a couple of months now since the workshop for Say Home, and I'm incredibly excited that we're entering the home stretch and can't wait to share it with you all.